Yep, I was a moron and had my microphone muted. Well, that was stupid. Thank you, though, for pointing that out. And I haven't gone that far. I'll have to make note of that. Yeah, so what had happened was I was doing some video recording yesterday for, for Gaming Nexus, the, new Shards of Infinity expansion. And the way I did it was I had my webcam and my camcorder set up. I think for whatever reason I muted my mic so it wouldn't come through because I was using Streamlabs to record the webcam footage. I didn't want the actual microphone to pick up, so instead of, you know, doing the smart thing and muting the mic, I muted the mic through Streamlabs. Whoops. I'm smart. So, yeah, I'll have to put a little addition onto the version of this one I uploaded to YouTube saying, hey, by the way, I goofed, and how that even is. And for about the first 13 minutes, you're not going to hear me. Not that I've really said much. Okay, I just want this thing added to my Pokedex right now, so I'm going to pop an Ultra Ball on it. If I can hit it correctly. Oh, come on. Got inside the circle that time. Okay, a little jerk. Really? Oh, there's another one. Second arrow shot at this. It's tiny. It's the exact same size as the one I just fought, visually speaking. Rise again. Throwing a nanab at it, so it'll slow down. There! I'll be honest, I kind of completely forgot about the Nintendo Direct. I will likely be streaming until probably around 6-ish, so if worst comes to worst, I'll catch the replay of it. Have they even announced what all they're really doing for it? Like if they said it's specifically for this or for certain game, or just typical Nintendo Direct, who knows what they're doing with it. And Graveler finally leveled up. Weeping Bell should be evolving in one level. And we have a new Pokemon to add to our Pokedex. Ghastly, the gas Pokemon, said to appear in decrepit, deserted buildings. It has no real shape as it appears to be made of gas. That is clearly a black ball with eyeballs. I would consider that a shape. Unless a Haunter pops up, I really don't care to try to catch another one of those things. I must have already fought that Chandler. Okay, now we can move on from this floor. Yeah, I haven't been hearing rumors about Mario Maker 2. Heard about Metroid Prime Trilogy coming to, what's it, the Switch. Fire Emblem, eh. I mean, I was never the biggest Fire Emblem fan to begin with. I mean, I like playing the games, but that's kind of the eh portion of the Nintendo Direct for me. Depending on how the stream goes, I'm guessing it starts about 5 o'clock Eastern. So depending on how the stream goes, I might cut out the stream early, may stop around 5, I don't know. I did put the title, Short Stream. I never said how short. So we'll see how it goes. Again, if worst comes to worst, I can always catch the replay. Pokemon. properties of Sucker Punch. It doesn't really do much. Oh yeah, definitely. I would be surprised if you were watching me at 5 o'clock as opposed to the Nintendo Direct. That's why, again, depending on where I'm at on 5, I might... Can I do something that far off? I might end up saying, screw it, watching the Nintendo Direct myself. At the very least, I'm finishing up Lavender Town today. So I can't wait. Apparently something I mouthed earlier, because I was an idiot and forgot to turn the mic on, was that I'm hoping at some point I'm going to make my laptop my actual streaming machine as opposed to using my PC. That way I can have everything right in front of me, including the chat. Instead of constantly looking back and forth, I can just kind of glance down. Also, I can then, I'm guessing, hear any notifications actually come through Streamlabs itself, because since I'm streaming through the PC, I can't hear any notifications that come through. I just have to keep kind of looking off to the side and hoping I catch it. So I'm thinking maybe Friday at some point. Yeah, I might want to use a Super Bug on the arena. So probably maybe Friday at some point, I'll probably end up doing test stream through the laptop, see how good it runs. Where is the ghost? You just had two of them, you... Alright, since Nidorina right now is my best bet to get through here, Gorgeous. All the time I played this, I still have not gotten used to how everything looks. Super Potion, use it on Nidorina. Let's go here and grab you. Oh goody, teleport. The favorite move of Abra's everywhere. Get you out of them. Or not. And a full heal. Something I've not experimented with yet is, I'm guessing, considering that there are future generation aspects with this game, I'm guessing that using a TM is not a one-time thing, that you can keep using the TM as much as you want. I'm not about to test that and find out. Because I think in terms of like the actual order of the games, I don't think... I want to say Gen 3 started that whole thing where TMs can be used over and over again. Not too worried about being burnt. Oh. Okay. I guess it wasn't worried about being burned. Considering she has only one, she only has the Haunter, that means it's more powerful than Pokemon that a channeler with two Pokemon have, and it's going to take a few more hits. Still not too worried, though. I don't think I bought Burn Heals, but I'm sure I have... I know I bought full games. Let's see. Handsome Pocket. I do have a Burn Heal, so I might as well use it. I bought some full heals. I got 13 of them, but... If I have the item specific for my status ailment, I might as well use that. Looking over there. I don't say this often, get away from me, Ghastly. Okay. Not you. Those eyes do kind of look a little hypnotic. Another single Haunter. So level 25. Probably Will-O-Wisp right off the bat. Okay, I avoided them. Kind of surprised by that. So I one-shotted that Haunter, and the one I just fought beforehand took 3 shots. So either every other Haunter is weak as heck, or the other channel had one buff Haunter. Or knowing Game Freak, both. And heck, they're not responsible, but I'm just going to throw it in knowing Niantic, both. So that is a heal for everyone. So I'm actually going to clear out all the other channelers first. I'm going to regret saying this. Throw out a Gengar or something, please. Something different. So let me find out what Nidorina evolves. I don't think the Nidoran lines were ones that evolved through training. I'm trying to think. Before Gen 2 and items were, or held items were a thing, I'm trying to think what evolved through training. I know Graveler, I know Kadabra. I thought there were a total of four Pokemon in Gen 1 that evolved through training. There was Kadabra, there was Graveler. Blanking on the other two. I think they're the Nidoran lines, though. If not, usually around level 36, around that area is when they would evolve, I think. Could be absolutely wrong. It's kind of sad, because I should know this stuff about that one, but my brain just kind of goes. That's when you're chomping on ghosts. Insert, I should have nicknamed Nidorina Pac-Man here, joke thing. It would make more sense though if the joke would have lasted more than one area. We have 4 Pokemon, wow. 21. Alright, level 25. Let's be getting into the more powerful channelers now. Not that it helps. Stay here and chew through them all. You're seriously gonna have 4 Gastlys, aren't you? Not gonna lie, I would probably be in trouble if dark types were not a thing in this game. But I honestly cannot remember what else is effective against ghosts. For some reason, I want to say psychic. I can't remember. Would be bad because I don't really have any psychic Pokemon leveled up. Oh, okay, technically Mr. Mime. We're gonna find out. Get out here, Mr. Mime. I'm near healing spot anyway, so. Like, what have I got to lose at this point? Yep, okay. I thought Psychic was super effective. So pretty much, I should have no problems getting back on this island. And the channeler turns into Ric Flair. Alright, you're next. Zombies. I'm surprised there's not really a zombie-type Pokemon yet. Unless there was in Gen 6 and 7, because that's about the time I really just started not even paying attention to remembering what Pokemon came out to. Actually, I take that back. If you were to give me a Pokemon, I could probably guess what Gen it's in. At least through Gen 1, 2, potentially 3. After that, there's a good chance I will not be able to tell you what Pokemon came from. Now we got the buff monster again. You can start a punch, that's fine. Do that. Should be okay. Second punch should be okay. Oh yeah, now I get the critical hit. Love getting the critical hit on the hit that would have knocked it out anyways. Everyone wants to say Vulpix was a trade evolve. Coming up, my boy. Hunter, but not the guest. Thank goodness for small favors, I guess. Seriously, why aren't these trains giving me great balls yet? And an ice stone. So, I forgot to bring this up. I don't think it's here. No, where is it? Power up pocket. So I got the Firestone. What? I think one of them have really been confused for Firestone. Oh no, it's when I was going through the different stones, I think, in Celadon, and there was like ice and leaf there as well. And I was trying to think, why would I? Okay, never mind. First off, I really need to backtrack something because Vulpix is a stone evolution. So, that out of the way, when I was at Celadon, I was trying to think, why are there ice and leaf stones in this game? Because Gen 1 didn't have those, and any Pokemon that evolved using stones used fire, lightning, and water. Well, I found out why they're in there. Or at the very least, I'm not sure about the leaf stone. At the very least, the Ice Stone is in the game for Alolan Vulpix. Because you use the Ice Stone to evolve Alolan Vulpix into Alolan Ninetales. Yeah, I'll be honest, before probably last month, and even last month I didn't stream that much. It was very sparse when I did stream, and one of my goals for this year is to try to stream more often, so I'm hoping to stream at least once a week, but I don't have a set schedule because for a while, early last year I think, I would stream every Friday, and having a schedule when I already work 5 days a week, it just felt more like work, and it just got to the point where I didn't really feel like streaming on some days. So basically streaming for me now is kind of when I feel like it. Though I do want to try to stream at least once or twice a week. Wednesdays when I stream, it's going to be not that long. Like, the latest I would stream today would be 6. I forgot there was a Nintendo Direct going on 5. So I might actually get through Lavender Tower and call it. I'm not sure. Or I may go through till 6 and just watch the replay the Nintendo Direct later. Which is probably what I am going to end up doing. Because I hate to stream for just 1 hour. Yeah, Wednesdays when I stream, it will likely be just for a couple of hours. Any other day, it all depends on what I'm doing, how long I feel like going. Whew, thank you for toughing that out. I was not expecting that to actually almost KO me. So, yeah, Mr. Mime, you're going to be swapping out for a bit. Or swapping in, rather. Yes, I will switch. Yeah, that is something else I've been definitely adamant about doing is uploading stream archives. I've almost been tempted to go back and try to edit and upload some of my older ones. I do still have a lot of my older stream files, but a lot of those were just speedruns. And usually my PBs on any speedruns I've done, I've uploaded anyway. The only thing I'd be tempted to really upload to YouTube would be, and I'm sleeping. Great. I started a self-imposed challenge a while back for Borderlands 2 where I only used white gear. Only really streamed it once or twice. But, really? Now I'm sleeping and I'm confused. I'm kind of confused in real life here, too. Basically, having dark-type moves in this game is a godsend for Lavender Tower. If Mr. Mime is the only psychic Pokemon I've trained so far. Actually, I've been keeping the majority of my team the same since I've started on the post. Oh, boy. You know what? Since I'm about to lose Mr. Mime, let's just do this. Expecting Haunter to both confuse me and put me to sleep. Of course, I just realized this is a level 32 Haunter as well. There. Yeah. I know this is a 2018 game, but to me it's still Gen 1, so I'm surprised that the coding is not so wonky in this game that you can hit yourself in your confusion while you're asleep. And somehow wouldn't wake you up. Well, I'm definitely getting plenty of money and Pokeballs out of this, which means more money. Okay. Back downstairs for a moment. Thankfully, there's a free healing spot right here. In terms of ghost types, I'm trying to think. I think Gengar would be my favorite ghost type. Of course, in like the first couple of gens, there weren't that many ghost types. But now, a while back, I did one of those meme chart things or whatever, where it's like, you have all your different types of Pokemon, you choose which Pokemon was your favorite of that type. I think I still got it saved on my phone. I'm pretty sure I put Gengar as my favorite ghost type. Of course, again, there's not a whole lot of ghost types. I'm loving the sporadic level changes in these channelers. Like, we just went through a level 32 Haunter, now we're back down to level 25. In the original games, they were kind of consistent. Like, they would rise up as you got further into an area. But this is like a heart rate monitor, or a, you go to a hospital, you have those heart monitors that go beep, beep. That's what this is. It's like 25-32, 25-32, just keeps going up and down. And that is your really wonky analogy for the day. I just compared Pokemon to a heart rate monitor. Then again, considering we're in Lavender Tower, which is full of ghosts, thanks for the demonstration, I guess it makes sense. Yeah, that looks better. Oh, now I catch it first try. Earlier, when I finally caught one, I think went through a few great balls, a few ultra balls, a couple raspberries. Honestly, I attempted to throw a nanab at it, which probably would have been the first time I've ever used a nanab in battle between this or Let's Go, or between Pokemon Go. At least, outside of just morbid curiosity, and you know, if I got them in Pokemon Go, I don't use them. Oh, hello. Yep. You gotta be kidding. So this is where I gotta fight the Marowak. Sorry, spoiler alert, the ghost. That's not a Pokemon, that is a Heartless. That's right. I got binoculars. What do you got? With a camera. So, something I'm curious about now. Did Gary know that was Marowak? Because if so, how? Okay, actually, never mind. I take that back. Because the way the Silphscope worked, I guess that ray of light it shone is what revealed it to be a Marowak. Whereas I thought in the original games, it was literally, you put it up to your face, and you can see what the ghosts are. Whereas here, it literally reveals what the ghosts are to anyone nearby. I did. Gotta keep remembering, this is a dumbed down version of Pokemon Yellow. Thank you. Great, so I am going to be fighting a Marowak in the final battle, aren't I? Right, can that hunter pop up again, please? So I figured I would not have encountered the... Ah, there you are. Figured I wouldn't have encountered Cubone's mother until I actually got to the stairs, not smack in the middle of the room. My god, that is huge. First things first, you're getting a raspberry right off the get-go. Of course you would. Yeah, these are like catching onyxes. Well, what's interesting is that I don't know how much of the beginning of the game you've seen. Because I named this character Garrick. I figured he's going to be my throughout the game rival, jerk or not. It's Gen 1, I'm going to name him Garrick. But then almost as soon as you get further into the game at the beginning, you come across Blue, who is designed like Gary. So technically, the real Gary Oak is in the game in a way. I really only seen the very beginning, and even then I don't think he was still that much of a jerk. So basically this game goes by the incredibly friendly rival policy. Which, gee, wouldn't that start black and white? Oh yeah, sorry. New Pokedex entry. Haunter, the gas Pokemon. By licking, it saps the victim's life. It causes shaking that won't stop until the victim's demise. Wow, that is dark. Yeah, anyways, up we go. I think I still got a Team Rocket fight. Yeah, so the person I named Gary is not the real... I didn't mean to shake that button. Is not the actual Gary, so to speak. I can't remember if the actual Gary I named Blue. Or that was just his name. Like, it's either I named him Blue because I already named my rival Gary, so whoops. Or he was by default named Blue. And now we get to fight Arbok and Weezing. Yeah. So I'm gonna go full on anime nerd here. At some point in this game, or another well, specifically this game, because it's Gen 1, I would love to see a random Team Rocket fight that's not Jesse and James, but rather Butch and Cassidy. Just for giggles. Or to at least see Jesse and James fighting against Butch and Cassidy like they tended to do. Can you imagine that? Weezing Narbok. So, Toxic... Narbok? Rock Slide, I think it's both? Yep, Rock Slide hits both. Yes, use Crunch on the Rock-type Pokemon. Okay, so... Okay, because Arbok is Poison Diamond. I don't know why I was thinking Arbok was something else. Okay, so we will now fight the snake. We need Rock Slide. As long as Bite goes through, the Rock Slide should take out Arbok. Oh, that hurt. That didn't take an Arbok. I'm surprised. Yeah, it's cool. Yeah, it's cool with Eevee. Should be nice if you can do like a Pokemon Stadium style of game where you could choose from different members of like Team Rocket, different antagonists and protagonists, different gym leaders throughout the series, and fight with or choose like three of six different Pokemon they could have, something like that. That would be interesting if they did something like that. Use Rock Slide if Swift won't take an Arbok. Okay, we've Melgru to 36. Let's use Poison Jab. Poison Jab, guys. Target is stabbed with a tentacle, arm, or the like, steeped in poison. This may also poison the target. One key vine whips through. You know what? I might actually regret this. I'm gonna get rid of poison powder. Yeah, I know I'm getting rid of guaranteed poison for potential poison. Poison jab actually does a decent amount of damage. I'm kind of okay with that. And rock slide knocks. Never mind. Not critical hit, that's why. So you're thinking, wait a minute. Rock Slide's not going to do much. A critical hit. And Graveler evolved. Graveler Weeping Bell. No, that's right. Graveler was trade only. So Weeping Bell's got to be getting close to evolution. And Vulpix has one more move it can learn. I think at 31 or 32 before I want to evolve it into Ninetales. When we okay, I want them to actually blast off at some point when they say that. That is the look of, I really don't care, just. I'm the guy who just saved your butt. That says a lot about Jesse and James when he doesn't even pay attention to the fact that they're right behind him talking. So now I believe you give me the Pokeflute, where I get the Wake Snorlax at some point. Yep. Oh wait, is the Pokeflute not the Wake Up Technique? Finishes up Lavender Town. Get heal up. What am I looking at with the Pokeballs? 66 Pokeballs. I am seriously considering just saying screw it and selling those and getting Great Balls at this point. Saffron next. Alright, and that confirms that the tea I got was specifically for this, so I didn't have to buy that water, but. Though I never did really figure out why would they not let you pass because they're thirsty. And Saffron. Trainer favorite. Come talk about all your favorite trainers here. Okay, let's see what this is about. Yes, you're actually Lieutenant Sturges' autograph. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if, of all the people I've fought in this game, if I've already fought the gym leader of Viridian City. Two premier balls that I probably won't use. Lure X items which I do not use. Dire Hit Guard spec. Actually, I can't super potions right now. I can't remember if I can go straight to Erica or if I gotta do story stuff first. We'll see, though, since we hit a bit of a point here. Let's do a quick save. Alright. Oh yeah, so, yep. Oh, with the saffron. Wait. Okay, the really show. Yeah, that wouldn't surprise me. Anyways, I am curious. Wow, I am apparently a moron. So, for whatever reason, unless I just really missed it, I was thinking Celadon City didn't have a gym. No, not chopped down. But, yeah. Thinking. Yeah, wow, that was a major goof. Why was I thinking Celadon didn't have a gym? Okay, so, place your bets how completely overpowered I am now for this battle. I'm not sure if you're meant to do the gym before or after the Lavender Town stuff. I don't know where the gym's at. Takes me off even more thinking that Gen 1 is the gen I know the most about, and yet here I am completely forgetting that Celadon has a gym. I'll be back. Good for you! When aren't you practicing your miming? Okay, that's right, that's the department store. Okay, so, where the frick is the gym? City is a gym. Where's the gym? Let's go back to the department store. Nothing over here. Well, there was an item and I got it. Probably why I didn't think there was a gym. Because I didn't see one. Nope, not in the market for guard spec, don't care. This is the game corner. Am I going blind here? Am I just going bonkers? Let's skip up. Snorlax goes om nom nom. This is Snorlax, the pillow Pokemon. I love that Snorlax mistook you for food. Oh, so I actually do have to battle it before I can actually catch it once. Yeah, I need to check all the signs. I mean, there's the one for Dire Hit, one for X Accuracy. Razor Leaf. I just noticed Snorlax is no longer poison. And I just noticed I have a timer. Did not realize until just now I have a battle timer. Great. Razor Leaf. Please, Brett. confuse it. Brush it up a little bit. I'm actually okay with it using Yawn. I've got another Awakening, I've got plenty of full heals. Helps it burn. Now the fun begins. Raspberry. Okay, that circle could not get any smaller. It was with a raspberry, Ultra Ball. Really? Ah, oh, you jerk. You know, game. You're kind of starting to tick me off here. I can't make these throws any more perfect, and they're with Ultra Balls. Thank you. Sleeping Pokemon will eat anything, even if the food happens to be a little moldy. It never gets an upset stomach. That's kind of scary. Keep going on this way. I see you. I see that Odrio up there. Yes, I'm going after the Dodrio before the Doduo. Yes, I'm a little citizen. And yes, I know I'm still an Ultra Ball. Is the Doduo, I would have switched. Wow. Dude, that was a shot. There we go. Caught the Dodrio before the Doduo. Dodrio, the triple bird Pokemon. One of Doduo's two heads splits to form a unique species. It runs close to 40 miles per hour in prairies. So, a Dodrio is formed by one of the Doduo heads splitting. Were Pokedex entries always this freaky? Come here, I still need to do a... Come here! I still need to do a... You... I'm gonna go back to Great Balls. Actually, you know what? Because I'm feeling sadistic. Wow, this is tight. Oops. No, I was not so close to catching it. Don't. Try a couple of Pokeballs before switching to Great Balls. Gotcha. Damn it. Wow, that overshot. Yeah, I probably need to sell the Pokeballs and go straight to Great Balls at this point. There we go. Just so it'll take less time as well. Yeah, if it wasn't for the fact that I do get a butt ton of Pokeballs, you pretty much get like 3 Pokeballs when you defeat most trainers. I'm surprised at this point in the game they're not giving me Great Balls when I defeat them. I guess we're getting into the 30s here on levels. I might have to go straight to Ultra Balls. I mean, I've got the money. But also, I've not actually found a shop yet that sells them. I don't know if Saffron does or not. And I completely forgot to read the Pokedex entry for that. Oopsies. Let's correct that. There we go. Doduo, the twin bird Pokemon. Its short wings make flying difficult. Instead, this Pokemon runs at high speed on developed legs. Its wings are so short, they're microscopic. Ah! Okay, meanwhile. Back to the hunt for the Celadon Gym. That was the one about the dire hit. No, that's the Celadon story. Excuse me. You don't help. Excuse me. You don't help. Explore down here. To the people watching this on YouTube, I'm just going to wait for the laughter to subside. Okay. And you just hit me? I might want to, you know what, screw it, I'll use items. I've got items to bring me back, I got plenty of money to buy more. I got a Vulpix, I got an Eevee. Mr. Mime's cute. Wow, she actually went for it. Now I wish I brought Snorlax in. Okay, these are gonna be grass types. Well, first of all, okay, I do have revives. Super potion. Picks Wooten Bell. Now I need to swap the arena for Vulpix. So No Vulpix can learn one more move? Actually, let's do this. I'm going to look up real quick and see what the last move is. I'm going to look up real quick and see what the last move is Vulpix can learn. See if it's even worth learning. I don't think I know. If I remember reading right, Ninetales won't learn anything else when I evolve it. Okay, yeah, Fire Blast at 31, yes. Wait. This can't be right, because I... Well, that's right, I didn't learn Roar. I forgot Fire Blast. Don't I know what I've been using, or... No, Fire Spin and Flamethrower. Okay, I don't have Fire Blast yet. Okay, so once I hit 31 and learn Fire Blast is when I want to go ahead and just evolve straight into, going to evolve into a Ninetales. And I'll show you the cute Pokemon that I didn't show you earlier. Okay, level-wise, what are we looking at here? We are looking at... Okay, high 20, that's not as bad as I initially thought. And dead. Burn trip crisp. Actually, if that thing goes right, I should hit 31 prior to Erica. Which is good, because then I'll have Ninetales for Erica. Let's fry up some eggs. And breakfast. Man, might be darker than the Pokedex in the reason. There's back here behind. Nope, nothing, because I can't go any further that way. So we'll go this way. Grass-type Pokemon, too. They're easy to burn. But, you're in a gym. This is the fourth gym for most trainers. Do you have anything that's not an Oddish, that's not a basic level Pokemon at this point? Not a Gloom or something. Okay, Weeping Bell. I'll give it that. I expected a Gloom before Weeping Bell, but sure. This might actually take a couple of shots. Or not. Fire Blast is 110. fire spin. It's weak. You know what? I don't use fire spin that much. I mean, it's nice, but it's low power to start with. I'd rather take fire blast. That means. Wrong button. Go to the bag. Power up pocket. Firestone. Use it. Now, here's what I'm curious about. Okay, actually, let me back this up. It says it's compatible with Eevee, but that is my original Eevee from the beginning of the game. And I'm not going to. But I'm curious what happens if you try to use an Evolution Stone on your original Eevee, because I've heard that the Eevee and Pikachu you start with cannot evolve. So we're going to go ahead and go with Vulpix 2 Ninetales. Worst comes to worst, find our Firestone. That's like a still on stream. I may save my game and then buy another Firestone, try to evolve Eevee and see what happens. It's like a little post stream or post game type thing, post video thing. Ninetales, the fox Pokemon. According to an enduring legend, 9 noble saints were united and reincarnated as this Pokemon. That's where the Ninetales come from, I guess. Nothing I have is compatible with the Ice Stone. Ice Stone would be for Alolan Vulpix. I think it's the only thing that the Ice Stone can be used for. Because in Gen 1, there was no actual Ice Stone. Yes, I was peeking here earlier. I was gonna come by later. Hey, we got a Gloom! I've got a Ninetales. Let's see, Fire Blast for Erica. Yeah, at this point, I'm just kind of expecting to mow down this gym. I mean, if worse comes to worse, I've got an Eevee and a Graveler like 8 levels higher than anything I've faced so far in this gym. I think I'm good. It's a shortcut, but I would be remiss if I didn't use it. Besides, if the Eevee can use its psychic ability to cut down thorns while sitting on my head, why not check it out? Yep, okay, that's just a shortcut. I figured. Yeah, where's the check? Definitely getting up to the upper echelon of Pokemon in this gym. This is the second straight Gloom. Okay, good to know that Ember can't one-shot. Save some throwers. Blended. What do you have? Yeah, this is a war I'm willing to say screw it and flamethrower. Plus, I know what Weeping Bell's capable of, and I'd rather not risk it. Tangela. I'm gonna switch because I do want to actually save some of my fire moves. I'm gonna put Grapple on there. Holy, that hurts. I mean, I get it, grass. Strong against rock. I think it would be that strong. Asteroid. Not gonna get much out of the Mega Drain. Enjoy your, what, 5 HP? Yep. I don't think Tangela is part poison at all, so... Field is toxic. So pretty much Mega Drain kind of negates the toxic. Thankfully, Bite can cause flinching. And then I'm faster than Tangela. Without being very effective, it still does quite a bit. This should actually do it. I do believe the poison from Toxic gets worse over time. This should take out. Yeah, for some reason I was thinking it's also part lightning. Hopefully grass won't be that good against it, and whoops. Well, lucky for you, I have a fire type. That is the first Bellsprout we've seen here. We saw a Weeping Bell before we saw Bellsprout. Go get him, Mr. Mime. Oh, I forgot Psychic is also strong against grass. Or is it at least part poison? I think both the Bellsprout and Oddishlines are part poison. Yeah. I swear I played a lot of Gen 1 when I was younger. As God's my witness, that Bellsprout's broken in half! Look at that, I'm gonna take my pick. They're both full of blood. Alright. Time for the actual gym battle against Erica. Oh, there. Wow. So you must find this boring if you keep sleeping through everything. I got a Poke Flute. Normally it only works on Pokemon, but I can bonk you in the head with it. Yes, I wish to, let's see, how's it put in WWE? Burn it down? Seriously, I think I am darker than the Pokedex in this game. Let's just throw a flamethrower right out the gate. Yep. Calling it now, this is going to be the easiest gym battle, because then again, I didn't really fight Erica when I first got here. But I think it's not like my Vulpix really gained much in terms of levels before I got here. Or between... between the end of the last video and now. So, maybe gained like two levels? Yeah, maybe like 29 in the last video. So yeah, not really a whole lot of difference. The big thing being, I would have had Fire Blast, which I've not used yet. And I would have evolved into Ninetales. So I've been a bit weaker, so... A bit more of a challenge, but I still have Mr. Mime. So basically, I would have been too much worse. I think it's time to finally get Fire Blast. And he avoids it. And then my god, that was overkill. Wasn't expecting the Fire Blast to crit. So basically, fourth gym. And thanks to actually bringing in Pokemon of the correct type this time, she got one attack off on me. Part of me feels slightly sympathetic. Seriously, I wonder what happens in Let's Go Pikachu if you high-five Pikachu's tail if it shocks you. And good if we get Mega Drain. I've seen worse moves. Alright. So now we can go on out of here. Maybe pull something real quick. just from how nervous it was. The fact I don't need to use any metal. And using this thing that... I'll give it this. Motion controls are good.
What?
Trying to hold my hand still on like the 5 pixels needed to actually do this. Alright. I'll heal here quickly. If I thought about it in the last video, I probably could have gone ahead and fought Erica, but eh. Yes, I'd like to rest my Pokemon. I seriously want to know if there's ever been anybody else in the history of running any Pokemon Gen 1 game that has used Mr. Mime longer than I have in this. I don't care what anyone says, I like Mr. Mime. Okay, so, as I stated I was going to do... Yeah, let's go ahead and save. The stones are not cheap. We're going to save. And then before I stop, I'm going to buy a Firestone real quick and see what happens when I give it to Eevee. Because I'm pretty sure she's not going to take it. But I'm just curious. Trying to think. I mean, some of the games I played on the Wii that used motion sensing worked okay. I'm trying to think of what I actually had that used it. Look at my games behind me. I don't have a whole heck of a lot. Ghost Squad worked pretty well. Of course, I was also using the Wii Zapper accessory for that. At least crossbow training wasn't bad. So, in terms of the games that specifically used the motion tracking, that was like one-to-one, it worked pretty well. Games like, I think it was, Twilight Princess, it was alright. Skyward Sword wasn't bad. In terms of like the... Well, Twilight Princess and Skyward Sword weren't one-to-one in terms of their sword movements. But the games I remember playing on the Wii U that was... that did the one-to-one movements, seemed to work pretty well. Okay, I think you're who I buy these stones from? Sorry, I got it from the counter. Okay, Leaf Stone. I don't know why I used the Leaf Stone. So yeah, so I saved before this. So that way I'm not out to 5,000. I don't have anything else I would need a Firestone for. Well, I technically do have other Eevees I could eventually evolve into Flareon. So, let's see. So if I try to use a Firestone on Eevee, what happens? Okay, Eevee doesn't seem to like it. Okay. You know, screw it. I'm not worried about resetting it. Eventually, I'll probably have to raise an Eevee to evolve into Flareon anyway, so I just kind of saved myself the trouble. Alright, so with that, get back outside. I will go ahead and save again. Actually, before I do go any further, what does my Pokeball count at? Sixty Pokés, 46 Greats, 11 Ultras. Actually, I've been to Saffron. Let's do this. Let's go ahead and fly to Saffron. This is my next target anyways. Might as well. Now I need to find the Pokemon. Because if they sell Ultra Balls, then yeah, I'm just going to start doing Ultra Balls. That's the fighting dojo. You know what? Do I have anything that could work against fighting? Because I've still got a little bit of time. You know what? Screw it. Let's go and do the fighting dojo. Provided I'm remembering type weaknesses correctly again, which I'm probably not. Actually, that works pretty well. So wait, this is a fighting dojo, why are you throwing out rock types? But you know what? That works. That really works. So yeah, this shouldn't take long at all. Really? From way across the room. I mean, I get that they want to make sure you fight everybody, but in the original game, if I recall, you had two walls going straight up with a black, two black belts on both sides and little gaps in the wall. So if you wanted to get to the final person in the dojo, you had to go through everybody. Like, you couldn't go around. This... you still can't, but it's just a weird way of doing it. Alright, see what you got. Not much. Not bad for not even critting. No fighting moves aren't going to do very much of a sweeping bell. Monk. And I don't think the... I don't think Wooden and Weeping Bell evolved through trading. I was pretty sure they were... through leveling, I just can't remember what level they evolved. I thought it was around 36, maybe it's closer to 38. I think when I first went through Pokemon Red, I think I got hit on Champ. I remember it was one of those decisions where it's almost like the Helix and Dome fossils, like you only get one, which means you're going to have to trade for the other one. Like, which one do I want now? I can't remember which fossil I initially took when I first went through Red. Pretty sure to hit on this. Maybe it didn't. submission, huh? Submission is a damage by recoil move? Remember some new ever game. In terms of the card games, I was terrible at making decks. So I made 3 decks. One was Psychic and Fire, which is probably my best. One was Grass and Fighting, which is probably my second best. And my third was Water and Electric, which sucked. And keeping in mind, most of the cards for these decks were around, like, no later than probably Fossil, maybe even later on to the Neo sets. Tells you how far back I played the game. But I don't recall ever, I don't think I ever played Hitmonchan or Hitmonlee in any of my decks. Now, as a collector, I've got the cards in my binders, definitely, but never actually used them in decks. Okay, so if I remember, Poliwhirl's a jerk. Oh, you're actually not going to... Excuse me, right off, huh? This room that we're battling in right now reminds me of the, training location in Street Fighter games, which is like a bunch of tiles on the ground and not much else. God, the thing is, he's got to need to train a lot more. Hi. Using the 2 Pokemon I'm about to pick one out of. Ow. And of course I'm paralyzed. Growing up, I started collecting with base set when it first came out. I tended to get at least one of the theme decks from each set, though, up through... I was getting one of each theme deck up through... So I got one of the Neo... I got one of the first Neo decks. I got one of the gym decks. I got a couple of the jungle, a couple of the fossil. I can't remember exactly which ones I got. I know in terms of gym decks, I got Lieutenant Surge. I stopped buying the decks after I won the Neo Destiny. Whatever the first Neo set was. I probably won't regret this, but screw it. Yeah. But... I kept collecting the cards up through the EX sets, Sky Ridge and Aquapolis, I think were the ones I stopped on. And yes, I know I'm putting any fire Pokemon against the water Pokemon, but I have a feeling that if I can get a one hit, I should be good. I stopped around there, then a couple years ago when the Pokemon National Championships came to Columbus, Ohio, I think it was 2016, I went in there, checked it out, and they had a couple of the online stores just set up, like Troll and Toad, a couple of our places. So I ended up getting, that was around the time the 20th anniversary sets were coming out, so... The only ones out at the time were Blastoise and Charizard. So sadly, Venusaur wasn't out yet. which was unfortunate for me because Venusaur is my favorite of the starters. I ended up going with Charizard, pulled an EX out. So first of any cards I bought for a long time, pulled out an EX, I think I have almost every pack. And then I got bit by the card collecting bug again and have been somewhat collecting ever since. I still get cards from every set, but I typically only buy them either when we get them in at work. Because I work at Best Buy, we get some Pokemon stuff in. So usually when we get the new collections in, I'll pick them up. And then usually at Gen Con, I'll get a box of a recent set. So between these two, I'm going to choose the one. I can't remember if I went with first or not, but between the two, I typically like Himmelchan better than Himmelman. Yes, I will take Himmelchan. Besides, worst comes to worst, whichever one I don't get, I'll just eventually trade from Pokemon Go anyways. Himmelchan, the punching Pokemon, punches in corkscrew fashion. It can punch its way through a concrete wall like a drill. How much you want to bet that Himmelchan's Pokedex entry is replacing the word punch with kick? It's probably not, but that would be hilarious. Hey, did I just see something really odd? Oops. Talk to you. Not that I don't like talking to you, but something just hit me. I want to make sure I saw that right. I'm pretty sure I'm wrong. Okay, good. For a minute, I thought Hitmonchan's weight was 1,046 pounds. I was going to think that either that, one, that's a really strong punching Pokemon, and two, how the heck is it heavier than Snorlax? Okay, so it's 104.6 pounds. Alright, so we are done with the... Oop! I saw an ellipses. Someone wants to talk. Sure, why not? Yeah, I occasionally play the online card game. I mean, I've had people in the past ask to know if I'll give out code cards. Honestly, I have actually been using the code cards. I've been trying to get enough cards to make a pretty good deck. I'm hoping at some point in the next couple months I can actually build a good deck and start playing online. If I do, I might eventually start streaming it. Overall, I'm not worried. That was better. If I survive this, I'll definitely swap out something else. Okay, cool. Yeah. Amateur. Which means you know she's gonna throw out Machamp next. Or Electabuzz. This game never really ceases to amaze me. You have two Pokemon in a fighting dojo and only one of them is fighting. Granted, Electabuzz can learn Thunder Punch, Thunder Kick, so granted, I'll give it that. Even still, it's not like Electabuzz is part fighting. I don't think it is. And of course I'm paralyzed. Just remind me I'd be taking a bit of a nap. Yep, 99. Or not. good. I'm no longer paralyzed. We're just going to confuse you. Try to. I was hoping to use something other than Thunder Punch, like Light Screen, so I can use Encore. I'm not sure if Encore actually works. Okay, so yeah, we'll be wrapping it up after this. I don't have a laptop plugged in, so its battery is actually running low. All that would happen, though, if the battery ran out, is I can go see chat. Words after this is about as good as the closest to after six is about as good as time as good of time as any to end the stream here in just a moment. Yes, you were totally defeated. Okay, I get Thunder Punch. Awesome. I can teach that to some electric type Pokemon. Hey, I can teach that to my Alolan Graveler. Yeah. Let's go around to the Pokemon Center. Which was not there. Yeah, I'd rather not trigger the next cutscene yet. I'll take the roundabout way again to the Pokemon Center. I'm exploring all of Saffron to make sure I don't miss anything this time, like the gym. So with that, I am going to go ahead and save and stop here. Alright, and before I go, I'm going to see who all is streaming what. Just see if there's anybody we can raid here. Never seen randomizer stuff for any game. It can be pretty entertaining. I've done most of my randomizers on stream have been The Legend of Zelda, but I have done a couple Super Mario Bros. 3 randomizers, and they're coming out with randomizers for a lot of things now. They recently have done Super Mario RPG, they've done Crystallis. Randomizers are entertaining. But I don't want to jump into a randomizer race that's almost done. They've just started. They literally just started. So that is actually perfect. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and... Oh, I can do that here. What am I doing? Okay, that is Speed Gaming 5. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and rate Speed Gaming 5. We'll be doing that here momentarily. With that, I thank you guys for watching, and I will see you whenever I stream next. In which case, hey, we got the fourth gym badge, finally! It just wasn't Saffron like I thought it would be. So, oops. And next time I stream, I'll make sure the microphone is unmuted from the start. So with that, I thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.